Hello dear friends, now we have to see the equations of motion. Newton has made three sets of equation of motion called as kinematic equation. Let us start with the first equation, that is equation describing the relationship between velocity and time. Let the object start from the point D in the graph. In this graph, if we say this is the x-axis and this is the y-axis, let the point start from D and reach till B. The object starts from point D in the graph with velocity u. So, this much part you will say that this is u. Its velocity keeps changing after time t. So, this x-axis has time t. So, the point from O till this is time t. It reaches the point B on the graph. Let us repeat. An object starts from point D and reaches to the point B. If it starts from D, then this much is the initial velocity. It increases its velocity and hence this is the time. So, on x-axis we have taken time and on y-axis we have taken velocity. Here, let us consider the initial velocity is u, that is OD. Starting point is D, hence OD is the initial velocity. And the final velocity is v. If this is the B point, it reaches till B. Let us draw a parallel to x-axis from B. It intersects the y-axis at C. So, your final velocity is V and that V is OC. This whole is the final velocity. It starts from D. So, this is the initial velocity. It reaches to B, the final velocity. So, we have taken OC as the final velocity. So, this whole part, that is V. And the time OE. Let us draw a perpendicular on the x-axis, or you can say parallel to the y-axis. And it intersects OX on the point E. So, the time here is considered as t. If the time is t, we say OE is equals to t. Now, we have studied acceleration. In acceleration, we say change in velocity upon time. Acceleration is the rate of change in velocity. Hence, the change in velocity upon time is the formula for acceleration. Now, change in velocity meaning final velocity minus initial velocity. For the formula, let us write in short, for acceleration we write A, and for the final velocity and initial velocity always we write A is equals to V minus U upon T, but here the values of U and V are taken. Now OC is V and OD is U, so we get A is equals to OC minus OD upon T. This t gets multiplied to A and you get AT is equals to OC minus OD. OC minus OD, so this whole line is OC and this small line is OD. So, if we say OC minus OD, you get CD. So, AT is equals to CD. We can say CD is equals to AT and we got the value for CD, that is the first equation, because OC minus OD becomes CD. We have drawn a line parallel to the y-axis passing through the B and this crosses the x-axis at E. Again, we have drawn a parallel to the x-axis through the point D and it crosses at A. So, let us take a parallel to the x-axis and it cut the BE in point A. Now, from this graph, we get this big line, that is the BE. BE means AB plus AE. AB plus AE, and you know that AB is equals to CD, AE is equals to OD, and this whole BE is equals to CD because these both lines are parallel. So from the graph we get BE is equals to AB plus AE, that is this whole line BE is equals to AB plus AE. If we take the values, BE means V, AB that is the CD, or you can say that is the AT, and AE is just the OD, that is the U. So for this equation, BE is equals to AB plus AE, we write V is equals to CD plus OD. Putting the values, BE is equal to CD. So putting the values, we get V is equals to AT plus U. Just changing the place, you get the final equation. V is equals to U plus AT, and this is the first equation of motion. Hence, we have derived Newton's first equation of motion.